Chad, I'm gonna be honest. You guys have been coming up with some advanced requests, but they made for some awesome shortcuts. Remember that iPhone app that just showed you movie trailers? Well, I made a shortcut to bring it back. And no more managing multiple summarizing shortcuts. This one identifies the file type and does it all with custom prompts. Saving recipes from Instagram to notes, that's great, but now a shortcut can also add those ingredients to your reminders grocery list. Get your favorite sports team schedule and add those games to your calendar events. Listening to your favorite podcast, will jump to watching it on YouTube at the same place you left off. Automatically sort your Apple notes and a ton more. I'm gonna be honest, I'm pretty excited to show you these. Now, many of these require Apple Intelligence, so you're gonna need iOS 26 and an iPhone 15 Pro or newer, but these can also run on your iPad or your Mac. And the first one is search for movie trailer. This one is actually using the movie database. Now, I'll share a shortcut down in the video description that's using an API key that I generated, but you can get one for free by signing up on their website. When you run this shortcut, you can search for any movie. We'll search for the Tron Ares, which I've heard is not very good. And upon searching for it, you can choose from a list. Again, this is from the movie database. It gives you a little overview to make sure you're choosing the right one. Tap the movie you intended to, and the official trailer will automatically open on YouTube, and you're watching it right there. And you can even search for older movies. Let's search for an old one like Jaws. Yep, there's the original, and there's the official trailer on YouTube. Now, technically, you could make this without Apple Intelligence, but I have found that Apple Intelligence action, and this is actually the private cloud compute model, really helps parsing dictionaries that come from API requests. So this one is Apple Intelligence. But shortcut number two, if you just want to see the latest movie trailers or movies that are out in theaters, this one actually doesn't require Apple Intelligence. When you run it, this is going to pull movies that are currently playing in theaters or coming soon. Again, this is according to the movie database. I put the release year next to the movie title, and you will see some older movies, but if some theaters are playing them, they show up in the now playing. Let's choose a movie, Him, and it opens that trailer right there on YouTube. I also added it as a home screen icon, so it looks like that old trailers app. Run it right here, you'll see the same menu. Choose one, that's the Lost Bus, the Apple TV original, and you have the movie trailer already playing. Number three, someone in my shortcuts community, which you can join at create.beard.fm, they asked for a master summarizer shortcut. So previously I shared different summarizing shortcuts for doing podcasts, PDFs, or documents. Well, this shortcut, it can receive something as the shortcut input, so you can run it from the share sheet. If there's no input, it will ask for files, and then it starts with a get type of the shortcut input. So if it's an MP3, if it's a PDF or other document, it's actually gonna run a different prompt. Now, if you wanna see what kind of media type the shortcut sees, you can add this quick look right here under get type, but I'll remove that because I just want it to run. Then after that, if type is Safari web page. So if you're in Safari and you share a website, it's gonna run through this prompt and you can customize this, which is the Apple Intelligence use models action. It's gonna show you that summary and then give you the option to share that to an app, copy it to a clipboard or more. Then if the media type is a PDF or a file, like a Word document or Pages document that you have in the Files app, it can run a different prompt. And finally, if it's an audio file, like a podcast episode, that media will be transcribed, there'll be a different prompt here, and it will show the result in Quick Look. You can add more if statements with type is and then different file types, but these should cover most of them. And then you can change the prompts however you'd like or what actions are taking place depending on the kind of file you share. So let's run the Summarize Master AI. I'll go to one of the episodes of Primary Tech Daily. That's a benefit to the paying members of Primary Technology, which you can listen to the weekly podcast at primarytech.fm or links down below to watch on YouTube. And here in the share sheet, I'll go to Summarize Master AI. And that quickly, it really transcribes fast, even on iPhone and iPad. There's a large summary up here, key takeaways. And remember, you can adjust the prompt for that summary if you'd like. And after it does the quick look, I'll see the share sheet and I can send that rich text, maybe add it to an Apple note, copy it to my clipboard, or do whatever I'd like. And so it will also work with a PDF. I'll share this from the Files app, run the Summarize Master AI. It will recognize that it's a PDF. And then we get the summary and key points from the PDF. Again, it'll bring up that share sheet and I can do whatever I'd like with it. Number four, this was actually a request from Nitish on Instagram. In my last Apple Intelligence video, which I'll link above, which had 20 Apple Intelligence shortcuts, I shared this one, which can pull a recipe from Instagram as long as it's in the caption, and then it adds it to Apple Notes. It formats it nicely with the title, ingredients, and steps. But Nitish asked, can it also put the ingredients on the grocery list in reminders? Well, using Apple Intelligence, yes it can. Link to download this shortcut is in the description. And as always, make sure after you download it, tap the eye icon at the bottom and make sure show and share sheet is toggled on. Now let's go to an Instagram reel with a recipe. So here's an Instagram reel. If I look in the caption, it has the ingredients and the steps. So I'm gonna tap the little share button, share to down here. And when we go to more, remember you can add these shortcuts into that top list so you don't have to hit more every time. I'm gonna do the save recipe and add ingredients. What that does is actually gets the raw HTML of this post, which includes the caption, and it uses Apple Intelligence to format it nicely in a note. Then it's gonna separate out those ingredients and add each ingredient to my reminders grocery list. Tap always allow if you see those pop-ups, and there the ingredients are now on the grocery list, and it even has the title of what recipe those ingredients are for under each reminder. Then I had it send me over to my Apple Note, and it has the ingredient steps and link back to the original reel there in Apple Notes. And if I go back to the reminders list, you'll see I added a recipe and I can see what ingredient this recipe is for here, and you can see the ingredients that were just added from that last reel. That was a great suggestion, and now you can save recipes easily and add ingredients to your grocery list. Now, Going Ghost in the YouTube comments saw my last video and said, can I get a sports team schedule and then add the games to my calendar? Yep, turns out you can. So for this shortcut, if you download it, you wanna find whatever website your sports team lists their schedule. So these are the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and it has all their upcoming games on that page. You need to find whatever page that is. And this should work not just for NFL, but any sports team schedule. It's gonna use Apple Intelligence to parse that information, and it's gonna use some more Apple Intelligence actions to actually parse individual events and then add it to your calendar. Now this last action down here, it's actually going to open the compose window to show if you wanna add that event. You can also choose what calendar these games save to. I'm saving it to my archive calendar, but adjust that. And if you just wanna add these automatically, you can toggle this off. But when this runs, it's gonna get the team schedule, all the upcoming games, also where that game is showing on TV, the location, date, and time. Then it's gonna show you each game that's on the schedule. You see, for the event title, it's gonna put the teams, who's playing, has the day and time of the game. You see it shows the right calendar there. And in the notes section, it says where it's playing. And if I wanna add this to my calendar, I'll just tap the check. Then I'll see the next game, day, time, where it's being played. And I can add this to my calendar as well. It's gonna do this for every game in the schedule that's currently listed. And again, you can toggle off that show compose sheet if you just want this to run and add those events automatically. Next, every time a new episode of my tech podcast, Primary Tech, comes out, I would share it with a shortcut. And the shortcut would pull the specific episode URL from Apple Podcasts. I would just show the Spotify show page and then pull the actual video from the YouTube channel RSS. The one specific episode URL I couldn't get was Spotify. But now with Apple Intelligence, I have the show page here. So all the episodes would just be listed there. I make that into raw HTML and then give that to the Apple Intelligence Use Models action. Because of the text limitation of private cloud compute, I'm using the ChatGPT extension, but it finds the link to the latest episode. So now when I run the shortcut, you'll have direct links to the latest episode on Apple, Spotify, and in YouTube. And this opens up in drafts. You can choose to open up in notes or just copy this to a clipboard. And just change the RSS feed at the top of that shortcut to your podcast of choice. And there's the direct links to the specific episode on each platform. Now enjoy these. I would appreciate if you support the channel by going to create.beard.fm. That's my shortcuts community. Over 2,000 of you have joined the shortcuts community, and over 600 of you are supporting the channel by being a paying member. You can join with $5 a month or $50 a year. You see those options at checkout. And when you become a paying member, you get access to my shortcuts request where I answer every request, try to build your shortcuts as best I can. You get access to my shortcut of a week where I share some shortcuts early and some that I don't even put on YouTube, like this shortcut, which I can't even talk about here. Plus my shortcuts GPT, which I use to help me make those movie trailer shortcuts using the movie database API. You get access to that and more. So I appreciate your support, just watching these videos, liking and commenting, and if you join the community, which you can do at create.beard.fm. All right, this next one is pretty wild. I saw this actually as a Reddit request, but if you're listening to a podcast in, say, Apple Podcasts, and you wanna go over to watch the episode, but retain your timestamp, well, technically, you can do that. This is gonna run from the share sheet in Apple Podcasts, sharing a link with your current timestamp. Then you need to know the YouTube RSS feed for the channel which hosts your video podcast. But if you do, you can put that here. That's gonna get the last 10 items. Hopefully the episode you're watching would be in the last 10 videos posted on that channel. If you think it would be more, you can increase that number. Then it's gonna use Apple Intelligence to match the title of the episode that you shared from Apple Podcasts with the episodes from that YouTube channel and take the timestamp, open the video on YouTube, and it should start playing at the timestamp you left off. So let me show you how this works. Let's say I'm an Apple Podcasts. You're listening to your favorite podcast, Primary Technology, and right now we're at 50 minutes, 50 seconds. Well, if I tap the three dots, I can share, and then in this share window, you'll see the from start. If you tap that, you can choose to share from the timestamp you're listening to. So make sure you do that, and then we'll scroll down and we'll run our open podcast video at timestamp. It's gonna look for that episode title on the YouTube channel. It's gonna take the timestamp and apply it to the link. Tap always allow the first time it runs, allow again, and it should open that episode on YouTube at the right timestamp, and it did. Now, let's see if it can match an older episode. Let's go back to last week's episode right here. I'll start playing it. Let's scrub forward. Here we are at about 21 minutes. So I'll tap the three dots, hit share, and do it from the timestamp. Do open podcast video at timestamp. I'm gonna run that shortcut. You see, it shouldn't ask me to allow again because I already did always allow. And it opened that episode of the podcast at the right timestamp. This was wild to me that it actually worked. Apple Intelligence doing some heavy lifting here. Now you can add like a menu and have multiple podcasts to choose from. The main thing is you need to have the RSS feed for the YouTube channel and make sure you're gathering enough items to match the episode title. But I thought this was really cool. Number 8, Jana here in the YouTube comments asked, can Apple Intelligence automatically sort my Apple Notes? Turns out it can. This shortcut is gonna get all your Apple Notes from the last week. It's gonna repeat with every note from the last 7 days. It's gonna use the Apple Intelligence Use Models action. Again, I have to use the GPT extension because when text is past a certain length, the private cloud compute model just errors out. So it's using the ChatGPT extension, and this prompt is basically saying, organize my Apple Notes into 4 different categories, journal, recipe, podcast, or other. Choose what topics relate to your folders that you have in your Apple Notes, and then whatever words you put here in each if statement, where it says if response is, change these, journal, recipe, and so forth, to match what you put in the prompt. This way, when a note matches that prompt and Apple Intelligence is actually seeing, does the contents of this note match this topic? It will then move the notes to those specific folders and make sure in each of these notes actions that you choose the folder that pertains to that topic. So let's go to my Apple Notes real quick. And you'll see these first two notes are not in the right folder. So this first one is a recipe. You'll see it's actually not in a folder right now. And this next one is a summary. I think this is a podcast, and those two notes should be automatically filtered into the right folders. I'm gonna run this. It is gonna go through your notes from the past week and then opens notes. And look, you just saw it change right there. And it moved this note to my recipes folder. This was wild that it just worked out of the box. Again, important. You have to have the folder set up and you have to change this prompt to match the topics or words that relate to your notes content. Now you can add more than 4. You can add 5, 6, 7, 8, however many you want. And then you'll just need to add an if statement per folder. This way, everything actually moves where it's supposed to. You can also change this to sort notes in the past year, in the past few days. But now Apple Intelligence can just automatically sort your notes into folders. And no, shortcuts can't move mail messages right now. I've had a bunch of people ask if it could filter spam or move email. There's no actions for that just yet. Number 9, someone saw my macOS automations video, which I'll link above and down in the description, but they wanted to transcribe audio files and only if certain words are found in the transcription to actually take action. We'll just call this scanner transcriptions. And basically you can run this on your Mac as an automation when you drop an audio file into whatever folder, and you can choose what folder this runs in those macOS automations. Again, that video explains how to do that. It's gonna transcribe that audio file. And then using the Apple Intelligence action, it's gonna send that transcript to this if statement, and now saying if this word is in the transcript or summary. And right now it's just the word trauma. You can change this word or you can add multiple words and you can say if all are true. So it has to have both the words trauma and other words that you specify. And then only if true will it create the Apple note and you'll have that added, and it's gonna show alert that yes, that new transcription was created. But if it doesn't include those words, then it's going to do nothing. Next, the oven cleaner in a YouTube comment wanted to know, can you take calendar events that are in your calendar, grab specific information, and put those in a number spreadsheet? Yes, you can. So this shortcut starts by having you choose 2 dates, a start date and an end date, and it will only get events in that time period. Then it's going to find calendar events, and this is important. Calendar is, choose whatever calendar you're wanting to pull these events from. Then with every event, it's going to repeat this process. It's using the Apple Intelligence Private Cloud Compute model. This could also use the on-device model because it's not a lot of text. It's going to parse that information in different ways. And then the final action, it's actually going to add that information to a numbers spreadsheet. Now, this action you will need to customize on your own. The number spreadsheet needs to already exist. You need to select that number spreadsheet here and actually have the exact table name and sheet name, all for this to work and actually go to the proper place. Now, just to show you the actual event. So this event is in my appointment calendar. It has an address, a time, you see the title there. And there's also some notes, which this shortcut is also going to parse. So when I run this shortcut, it's gonna have me choose a start date. I'll choose today. An end date, I'll choose next Friday, so it'll get all events in between those two dates. It's gonna find that event, parse the information. We wanna tap OK, it's going to access the file, and then it's gonna go over to the number spreadsheet, and you'll see it added a row with that information, the title of the event, the date and time that it's happening, the location or address, and any notes that you had in that calendar event will also be added to that spreadsheet. You can have these added to the top or bottom of the spreadsheet, but you can definitely parse the calendar information and move it to a spreadsheet with this shortcut. Those are 10 really fun shortcuts, but one bonus one, this was a request. This shortcut will actually summarize Apple News articles. You can run it from the share sheet in Apple News, but this person wanted to be able to hear, maybe just read aloud the summary or the full article, or just save it to Apple Notes. So I added a menu option here that when you run this shortcut, you actually get those options. So for instance, so let's go to Apple News and try it out. So here's an article in Apple News. I'll tap the share button. Make sure you tap the eye on the shortcut, by the way, and show in share sheet so you can actually run it. Apple News Read Summary is the name of the shortcut, and it's going to get the information, summarize it with Apple Intelligence, and then give me the option if I want to hear it, either the summary or the full article out loud. Remember, tap Always Allow the first time you see those. And now I can choose to speak the summary, speak the full article, or bring the text of this article to Apple Notes. I'll choose Speak Summary.
Financial difficulties for farmers by delaying farm loans, market reports, and cash bailouts, just as they need to plan for the...
And I can just read the summary, or if you want the full article read to you, you can choose to do that too. I hope you enjoyed those. Again, I would love for you to join my shortcuts community, create.beard.fm, and you're also supporting the channel there when you become a member. I also put the last video with 20 Apple Intelligence shortcuts. That video is right here. And subscribe to my tech podcast that comes out every Thursday right here. Oh, and subscribe to the channel and hit that like button if you haven't. Leave your shortcuts request down in the comments over on social media. Thank you so much for watching and your support, and I'll catch you next time.